Hey guys, what's up? So again, this is my week of Christmas films. I thought I would do How the Grinch Stole Christmas. This is an interesting film because one, I'll be slightly biased because I love Jim Carrey. I genuinely love Jim Carrey. Jim Carrey and Robin Williams, rest in peace, were like my two favorite comedians growing up. They pretty much set the scene for comedy for me as a child. So I'm a little biased, but to talk about the film, so a couple of things. It's interesting when you're dealing with something like a Dr. Seuss type of style thing, which is a very larger than life, but very at the heart of it, like sweet natured. Even with something like this, sweet natured, like overly sweet natured, it can be a little bit campy, can be a little bit cheesy. And I don't think this film was any different than that. And so overall, it was the case, you know. It's a little bit of a campy film. It's a little bit cheesy at times. So they knew what the strength was. It was the casting choice. So if you don't like Jim Carrey, so for some people, this is like the only Jim Carrey film they like. Totally understand. But it's they understood the casting choice of Jim Carrey as the Grinch, and wow, it's pretty insane because that is the whole film, and they knew that, and they let that breathe. They let Jim Carrey do what he wants. But I really like this film because a lot of times Jim Carrey gets to just do whatever he wants, and sometimes it's a little bit, it's just like a comedian taking over the course of the film. I thought this one was cool because they gave him parameters. I think a comedian can really shine. A lot of people think a comedian shines when they just let them go. I think improv is very important. There's no way this film didn't have any improv in it. It for sure did with all the takes they did. But they gave him parameters to the character, parameters to the movement. The director worked with Jim Carrey to kind of figure out like, what does this character look like? It's so great. It's so great that gave him range to play off of, as opposed to just go too crazy. That gave him range on how crazy he can be, but when he's supposed to like keep it reserved, and that was good. So I think the best part is Jim Carrey, for some people that don't know, is a very strong dramatic actor. Like a very strong dramatic actor. Please go watch Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind. I believe I said that correctly. Go watch 23. Go watch, you know, a lot of his films that are like, he knows how to play drama. It's not his first time. It won't be his last. And this one was good. The reason I bring it up, because he got to be funny and do his things. I never even really laughed out loud in the film. And I think that was what was missing. I really didn't have that good hearty laugh, but I just loved watching Jim Carrey play. The thing is, on the character motivations, is he's like almost like a Scrooge. It's basically a Scrooge storyline. And it kind of grows in the end, and Jim Carrey really sells that. The moments where he realizes he's gone too far with the presents, the moment he, like, the way he interacts with the girl, those things are really great. To talk about outside of the character for a second, the costume design and set design's amazing. Like, it's just amazing. They did such a good job. That film did a really good job. You wouldn't expect that from a live action version of this film. It's really great. Some people didn't even recognize some of the actors, and there were some pretty big actors in the film, big actors like from the 90s and things. But like, so that was amazing. There was a lot of sweet moments, but I don't know. You didn't really resonate with the people of Whoville, and I think that was missing. Like, you didn't feel for them, you didn't care for them. I think that element was missing. They kind of was just a backboard for Jim Carrey or the Grinch to play off of. And I think that's fine because that's kind of how the story is. But I think it was that was like a missed opportunity to really flesh out the Whoville characters, make you love them, not just like love the way they look, love their cuteness, love their community dynamic, but really love them. That would make the Grinch element hit harder, and that would make their relationship as a people better. And I think that would have been really good. Yeah, there's a lot of great things. They did a great job. I know he has a dog. The way Jim Carrey played off the dog is amazing. He really needed that, or else it would have ran dry. So that was like a perfect choice of like how they utilized the dog as like a sidekick, but not really, it's just a dog. Like, I love that. It didn't make the dog like larger than life. It was just a dog, and it was like basically Jim Carrey's way of like not going crazy. Perfect choice. That's like so Jim Carrey's, like not being too crazy for that. So in terms of like, would I recommend, like, do I, not even recommend, do I think this film is amazing? It's not my favorite to watch. I don't watch it every year. But when I really need to watch a character actor thrive, it's the film I go to for Christmas, for sure. It's actually just one of the films I would go to for watching a character actor thrive and really not judge the character they're doing. That's great. I mean, look at what he was wearing. Look at what, see, and do you see like the way he like did not judge the character. He went for it. That, in my opinion, on an acting level, is like one of the perfect ways. If you ever wanted to understand the concept of don't judge your character, or if you judge your character, people will see it. That is very, very adamantly true. And Jim Carrey did a really good job of not playing into that. He went for it. He sold it. He sold it throughout the whole film. He never once let his guard down. He just constantly pushed the character forward. And staying true to the character. I thought that was great. It's really easy when you have like a big character type of thing to like lose it during certain moments, the somewhat comedy moments or the certain dramatic films, you kind of, dramatic moments where the character's kind of hitting the end of the arc, you could lose it. He didn't. Staying true to the character, Christian Bale does a really great job of this, staying true to the character while going through the actual character arc is a lot more challenging to do than a lot of non-actors or a lot of just regular viewers think it is. It's actually very difficult. It's really easy to let things slip, to let things crack, and he did an amazing job. Plotline-wise, it served its purpose. It wasn't unpredictable. It wasn't, like, ridiculous. It almost felt like it was actually a very simple plot, little short plot, and it kind of took a little bit too long for it to happen. In my opinion, I think it was, like, a plot that would have only served like an hour or so, and it went on maybe do a little too long, or the plot could have been fleshed out a little bit more, but overall it served its purpose. I really go to just watch Jim Carrey play, and that's pretty much it. So I think it's less of a film as just like a character moment, and just like a character study on like what it looks like to just act in those different with those different character traits, and it was great to watch. As a film, it's okay. It's not my favorite, but Jim Carrey, keep doing what you're doing. It's freaking amazing. All right, guys, on that note, that was day two. I don't actually know what order I'm gonna do this in, so I shouldn't say that. But on that note, guys, I'll see you guys in the next Christmas countdown video. All right, guys, bye.